I have no financial disclosures. Let me begin with a patient. This is a 32-year-old gentleman who had chronic uveitis for 4 years, which he diagnosed as ocular tuberculosis and treated. And with the course of time, he developed cataract. And he needed cataract surgery, and the vision had significantly reduced. So this is a typical patient that we often encounter. And the challenges in this kind of patient is control of preoperative inflammation before the cataract becomes significantly advanced. And also, these patients have small pupils, so intraoperative pupillary management is an important issue. Also, we need to control the preoperative inflammation, postoperative inflammation, to have a good outcome. And even if we have a very good cataract surgery, the posterior segment lesions like preoperative or even postoperative, like cystoid macular edema, can affect the visual outcome. So these are challenging cases, and the topic of my presentation is to report the visual outcome and risk factors for cataract surgery in uveitis. So we are going to report the visual outcome and the prognostic factors. We have tried to identify certain prognostic factors. So this was a retrospective case series that we did from January 2005 to 2018, and we excluded any patients who had less than 6 months follow-up. And we defined all the uveitic terminology according to the Sun nomenclature. So the medical records were reviewed for the demographic characteristics, the clinical features, type of uveitis, treatment prior to surgery, type of cataract, intraoperative details, and intraoperative and postoperative complications, and also the visual outcome. We defined a good visual outcome as a spectacle corrected distant visual acuity of 20/40 or better. So we had 221 eyes, but we excluded, and so ultimately for the analysis we had 175 eyes of 155 patients. The male female ratio was more or less same, and most of the patients were young middle-aged adults with the mean age of 44.6 years. Most of the patients had anterior uveitis, but we also had nearly one-fifth of cases who had intermediate or posterior uveitis. A variety of immunosuppressive therapy, both topical and systemic, were done to control the inflammation before surgery. Only topical steroids were used in 34%, but we also used immunosuppressive therapy like azathioprine in around 10% of cases. We waited for 3 months of cataract uveitis control before the cataract surgery in nearly 70% of patients. But in 30% of patients, because of advanced cataract, we had to operate earlier, and this time range was between 1 to 2 months. Most of our cataracts were the posterior subcapsular type, but we also had a significant percentage, around 23%, who had presented with total cataract. Most of the surgeries were done by phacoemulsification, that is around 77%, but 17% and 6% of cases respectively were done with extracapsular or small incision cataract surgery. More than 50% of patients required intraoperative pupillary management, which was done either by stretching the pupil with Osher's Y hooks or using iris hooks or by multiple sphincterotomies. Most of the lenses were acrylic intraocular lenses, but we also had around 34% of patients whom we had to implant PMMA lenses. The mean visual acuity improved from 1.27 logMAR values, that is approximately 20 by 400, to 20 by 40 at 1 month, and remained at around 20 by 50 at 6 months. The difference between the preoperative and first and 6 month follow-up was statistically significant, but between the first month and 6 month, it was not statistically significant. Around 58% of our patients had visual acuity less than 20 by 200 before surgery, which improved to around 65% of patients having corrected visual acuity of 20 by 40 after surgery. When we look at the improvement in visual outcome according to the types of uveitis, we find that the maximum improvement was, of course, in anterior uveitis, and panuveitis and posterior uveitis had lesser satisfactory outcomes. Amongst the individual entities, Fuchs and HLA-B27 had good outcomes, while VKH and panuveitis cases had worser outcomes. We didn't have much of intraoperative complications. Around 4.6% of cases had posterior capsule rupture. We had multiple patients who had postoperative uveitis, either one or two episodes. CME was the most common complication of 36%. We had ERM formation in 13.7 patients, and we had other posterior segment complications also. If we look at the prognostic factors, a preoperative quiet eye of 3 months duration, and absence of posterior segment disease, either pre-existing or post-operative, a good pre-operative visual acuity before surgery, or a good post-operative outcome at 1 month. These were significant prognostic factors for a good outcome, whereas post-operative uveitis was a prognostic factor for a poorer outcome. So if you go back to our patient, this is one of the better cases, and we had a lot of cases like this also. At 1.5 years follow-up, his corrected distant visual acuity in both the eyes was 20/30 and 20/20, and his eye is quite. So if we compare our presentation with another Western presentation to give this thing, so we find that our patients were younger, they had worse pre-op visual acuity, they had more comorbidities, the surgeries were more complicated. However, we had a marginally improved visual acuity. And if you look at the prognostic factors, we find that most of the prognostic factors like preoperative visual acuity are important enough in controlling for a good outcome. So the key message is that you have to have a good preoperative control. Any preoperative lesions, posterior segment lesions are indicators for a poorer outcome. Thank you.
What was the kind and period of maintenance that you have kept these patients on after the treatment?
That is before the cataract surgery?
After the cataract surgery.
They have been, depending upon the uveitic status, some of them are still on follow-up with say one to two drops of topical steroids, and they are there. Some are like, we have around 30% who are still in follow-up with us. The rest have been lost to follow-up, because this is retrospective data from 2005 to around 2018.
And is there any difference in the kind of patients that you've seen, where you've done the surgery earlier than 3 months,
yeah,
where you say the cataract had advanced, with the ones which you have done after observing and reducing the inflammation and observing the 3 months?
Yeah, recall the ones in which we had to actually operate earlier than the 3 months, and our quiet eye was say 0.5 cells or less, the outcome was poorer. They had more post-operative uveitis. But we couldn't actually wait for that long, because I showed around 20% of our overall patients had total cataract, and some of the cataracts were very advanced, involving both the eyes. So having 3 months of control, we couldn't maintain it in all. But we did see that if you have 3 months of control, the outcome is far better. The uveitis rate is less. Sometimes in one or two cases we have had acute fibrinous uveitis when we had operated earlier, but because it was a retrospective, we didn't have much control, and we also couldn't keep control between the 1 and 3 months gap. But we didn't operate anyone less than a month. At least we waited for a month for the cells to come down to 0.5.
So what is the duration between subtenon and the phaco surgery or SICS, whatever you have done?
Wherever we gave subtenons, I don't have an exact data, we didn't look into the data per se for subtenons and all, it was at least a month.
Some month.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah, there is this thing what you call subgroup of leprosy patient. I can't show it, but it is there. But they mostly they are anterior segment, so their outcome is not bad, though they have a lot of, if they don't have BSKs or if the cornea is fine, then the outcome is better. The only thing is that the pupils are very small, posterior sign, so you need to do the intraoperative management, intraoperative management for the pupil. But otherwise, the outcome is not bad.
Yeah. Have you ever used OFDA or
No, no.
Thank you very much, Dr. Samrat, sir.
Thank you.
We will ask Dr. Aditi Anil Kumar.